let me take just a couple of minutes to sort of position the rest of the workshop for you. As Steve pointed out, changing the energy system is a monumental task. I mean, it is a pain. And so that's where we started with all of this, and the workshop has a couple of points of origin. One is a project, this project with the American Academy, to look at the societal and institutional consequences of trying to change a thing as big and implanted in our society as the energy system. The other source was a report by the President's Council of Advisors on Science and Technology that came out in December that focused a lot of attention on how do you get the technology the DOE and others have been developing into use, and in particular recommended that DOE and NSF jointly fund a social science research program. So it just seemed that these two streams came together. We'd given at the Academy a little thought to this problem. DOE and NSF were taking this recommendation quite seriously, and it just kind of seemed to gel to have this kind of a conference. So what are we going to try to do? Well, it's a first step. Let's recognize that. We'll get as far as we can, but there's a lot more to do after this conference. Its purpose really is to begin the conversation between the energy policy community and the social science research community. And I think it will be a success if in the process of identifying, in the following ways. First, the energy policy community identifies a few issues of concern to them that the social science community has already thought about and can help resolve now. In addition, I would hope and very much think we can find a way for the social science community to identify some energy policy issues that concern the energy policy folks, and Steve has laid out a bunch of them already, that where social science research of a fundamental sort can really help advance the ball and begin to create that research agenda that Steve was talking about. But I see both the research agenda as well as, you know, some actual immediate help from the social scientists, because I have been thinking about this stuff for a while. And finally, I guess as a major success, if you all exchange business cards at the end of this so you can keep talking, that would be great as well. Workshop is organized as follows. As you know, there's six panels. Really, there are kind of two pieces to it. The first three panels have to do mostly with behavioral responses to changes in the energy system, how you deal with energy efficiency, why don't people do it, response to new technology, and so forth. The second three have to do with the institutional issues. These are talked about less, but unless we can figure out how to write the right kind of regulation for CCS and develop policy frameworks that last for more than an hour and a half on the Hill and get the federal-state relationship sorted out, which I think is different in energy, as our two utility commissioners will tell you, than lots of other endeavors. Unless we get all that sorted out, we can't sustain the kind of program that's clearly required to make these decadal changes in the energy system. So the institutional stuff, less talked about, but important. We'll end our afternoon with a breakout session where we're going to ask all of you to tell us what you think are the low-hanging fruit in terms of what we know that can be useful now, in terms of the issues that need to be studied by the social science community that will be the greatest help over the next few years to the energy community, and how to continue this conversation. And in the end of the day, we'll write a report and let you see it. And that's the nature of the workshop. Let me end by thanking you all for being here. This is really a terrific group. Thanking Leslie and the staff of the Academy for putting it together, and particularly the ever resilient John Randall. as always, John is ahead of us, who's just done an absolute job as the chief staff person on this enterprise. Leslie wants to say a word, but let me finish with one little bit of logistics. We are going to adjourn from here, move to 307 for the panel discussions. We'll come back here for lunch. Leslie.